Hi guys, welcome to this video looking at how half equations can be used to show what happens to ions during electrolysis. So nice and simply then, a half equation is something that shows you what happens to the electrons during electrolysis and how you get back from the ions to the actual elements. And the perfect way to explain what's going on is to use an example. So we're going to have a look at lead bromide. It's one we've looked at in the past, it's one you need to know for the exam. So if I have molten lead bromide, when I electrolyze it, it will turn back into lead, which will go to my cathode, and bromine, which will go to my anode. So if I start off with lead then, at the cathode, we know the lead ions are turning back into the metal lead. So I'm going to start off with Pb2+, and I've got to end up as Pb. So the way to figure out what's going on is to have a look at the electronic configuration. Now, if something is 2+, it means it's lost electrons. So I've got a metal with a full outer shell, and I want to go back to lead. Therefore, I want to give it 2 more electrons. This means that my lead ion, which has lost 2 electrons, needs 2 electrons added to go back to my lead metal. So my half equation will be Pb2+ plus 2e- goes to Pb in brackets S to show that it's a solid. If we move on to the anode then, so I'm going to take my bromide ions, which is Br-, and I want to turn them back into bromine. Now, if you remember, all of the halogens, all of the halides are diatomic, so they go around in pairs. Therefore, I've got to have 2 Br- ions. So start off with my Br- ions, and I'm going to go back to Br2. So what's happening in terms of electrons? Again, draw the electronic configuration. For it to be Br-, it's got to have a full outer shell. So it has 7, it's gained 1 to get 8. And I've got 2 of them, so 2 with full outer shells. I want to go back to my bromine molecule. That is covalent. So if we have a look at the covalent bonding, as you can see here, it's got 2 shells, 1 shared pair of electrons, both with 7 electrons each, the shared pair giving me 8, so they've got their full outer shell. The difference between the number of electrons is on the left-hand side, I have 2 with full outer shells, so that is 8 plus 8 is 16. On the right, I've got 2 with 7 and a shared pair, therefore I have 14. So what have I done? I've taken away 2 electrons, and if I've taken away 2 electrons, I put them on the right-hand side of the arrow. Now at this stage you might be thinking, how do I do that? How do I do that from scratch? So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go through some step-by-step guides of how to write the half equations. So number one, you need to figure out what ion goes where. So if we start off with chlorine, you know that's a non-metal. Non-metals are anions. Therefore, they're going to go to the anode. Sodium is your metal, therefore it's a cation, and therefore it is going to go to the cathode. Once you know which ion is going to which electrode, it is then easy to figure out the charge. So cations, you know, are positive, positive. So sodium, which is in group 1, loses 1 electron, becomes Na+. You know it's going to go back to the metal, so it's just going to go back to Na. The next thing you need to do is work out whether the ion needs to gain or lose electrons to get back to its original atom. So sodium, group 1, has lost 1 electron, therefore it needs to gain 1 back. The next rule is if it needs to gain 1, add it to the left of the arrow. If it needs to lose 1, add it to the right of the arrow. So sodium, which needs to gain 1, I put it on the left, so it's Na+ plus E- goes to Na. If it's the anode, so chlorine is in group 7, it's a minus, therefore to get up to a full shell to make the ion, it's gained 1 electron, so it has 8. It needs to lose 1 to get back to the chlorine atom. Therefore, I put it on the right-hand side of the arrow, just like this here. The final step is to make sure that it's balanced. So if we have a look at the half equation of Cl- goes to Cl2 plus E-, the first thing I need to figure out is I've got 2 chlorines on the right-hand side. Therefore, I must have 2 chlorine ions on the left. If I have 2 chlorine ions, both of them need to lose an electron. Therefore, I've got to have 2 electrons on the right-hand side. So my full balanced equation is 2Cl- goes to Cl2 plus E-. Right, let's have a look at some actual examples then. So we're going to go with copper sulfate. Now, what we'll do is a quick recap on how you know what elements, what ions go to which electrode. So for copper, for your cathode, it's either got to be Cu2+ or H+ going to the cathode. Copper is the least reactive one, therefore that is going to form. So I'm going to go from Cu2+ back to copper. I've got Cu2+, therefore I must gain 2 electrons. So it's Cu2+ plus 2e- goes to Cu. At my anode, I've either got OH- or I've got SO4 2 minus. There's no halide there, so therefore it's going to be my OH minus. So what I do here is I have my OH minus, and remember that forms oxygen and water. Now what you need to do at this stage is balance it. So before you do anything about the electrons, figure out how many oxygens and hydrogens you've got on both sides and make sure it's balanced. So I'm going to double my water and I'm going to put a 4 in front of my OH minus. That way I have 4 of every atom, 4 oxygens and 4 hydrogens. It also means I've got 4 negative charges. This means I need to add 4 electrons to get it back to the normal state. So on my right hand side, I put 4e minus. That is a difficult one. My suggestion would be learn it. If we have a look at sodium chloride solution, at the cathode, I'm either going to get H plus or Na plus. Sodium's in group 1, therefore it's reactive, so I'm going to get hydrogen formed. Then at the anode, I've got a halide, so chlorine is going to be formed. So I start off with my H plus. I know that's going to hydrogen. You should remember hydrogen's diatomic. Therefore, I've now got to balance it. So I've got H plus, that's lost one electron, so I need to add an electron on, and then I need to balance it. 2H plus plus 2E minus goes to H2. At the anode, this is the one that you saw earlier, I've got Cl minus, I'm going to Cl2, and I've got to take an electron away. I've got 2 chlorines on the right, so I need 2 on the left, and 2 electrons, just like that. If we have a look at sodium sulfate, again, you're starting to see the pattern here. We look at the one that is the least reactive, which in this case is hydrogen. And then at the anode, I haven't got a halide, so I'm going to have my OH minus go in there. So it's the same thing again. So I can put in my half equations, H plus plus E minus goes to H2, and then balance it. 2 hydrogens, and therefore I need 2 electrons. At my anode, I've got my OH minus. I'm going to O2 and H2O. I'm gaining an electron on the right-hand side, so I can put a 2 in front of the H2O, a 4OH, and therefore I need 4 electrons on the right. If we have a look at sulfuric acid in water, there's only one thing at the cathode, which is H+, and at the anode, I've got either SO4 2- or OH- again. So again, you're seeing the same thing. So H+, needs to gain an electron to go back to hydrogen. Hydrogen's diatomic, so there's 2 of them, so I need 2 H+, and therefore 2 electrons. At the anode, again, same thing. I've got OH minus. I go to oxygen and water. I lose an electron. I then balance it. 4 OH minuses means I need to lose 4 electrons. And there is my balanced equation. And then let's have a look at a molten one. So in this case, there's no water. So I've got aluminium chloride. So the only things I'm going to get is aluminium and chlorine. So I can then do my half equations. So I'm starting off with Al3+. I'm going back to aluminium. And to get back to aluminium, I need to add 3 electrons on. So it's plus 3E minus. At the anode, you've seen this one before. I'm starting off with Cl minus. I'm going to chlorine because it's diatomic. And I'm taking an electron away. 2 chlorines means 2 Cl minuses, and therefore 2 electrons. Right, let's see how much you've picked up from that then. So a couple of questions. Number 1, complete the half equations for the following electrolysis reactions. So here you don't need to know which one's the cathode or anode. You've just been given them and you've got to complete them. So you have Na plus going back to Na and F minus going to F2. So have a go at both of them. Remember for the second one, you'll need 2 fluorines, so remember to balance it. Question 2, you've actually got to do it from scratch. So it says write half equations for the anode and cathode for the following electrolysis reactions. So part 1, you've got CuCl2, it's a liquid, so you've just got your Cu2+ and Cl- ions. Have them going back into their normal atoms and elements. Same with MgBr2 for part 2, you have Mg2+ and Br-. Part 3, they haven't given you the charges, and you've got an aqueous solution, so you've got to figure out, are you going to have the metal, or are you going to have hydrogen, are you going to have the hydroxide, or is there a halide? And then for part 4, it's back to a molten one, you've got Fe2O3. Here you've got to work out the charge of iron, Fe, and then use that to figure out what's happening to iron at the cathode and what's happening to oxygen at the anode. Pause the video, see how you do, and we'll have a look at the answers in a minute. Right, let's have a look and see how you've done then. So question one, first thing you need to do is figure out what's happening. So I'm going from Na plus to Na. So if it's plus, it's a metal, it's already lost an electron, so it's got to go back and gain an electron. So start off with my Na plus, I'm going back to Na solid, so I've got to add an electron to it to get back to Na. So my electron goes on the left-hand side. I only have to add one electron back because it's Na plus, therefore it's already balanced. So you get your one mark for Na plus plus E minus goes to Na. Question two, I know I've got my F minus, I know I'm going to F2, so what have I got to do? F minus is something that's got a full outer shell and had an electron added to it, so I've got to take an electron away, so I'll put it on the right hand side. However, I don't stop there because I've got F2, so I need to double my fluorines on the left, and therefore I'm taking two electrons away, one from each fluorine, so I need two electrons on the right hand side. On to the second part then. So write half equations for the anode and cathode for the following electrolysis reactions. So it's a liquid, therefore I only have my Cu2 plus and Cl minus ions. So if we start off at the cathode, I'm starting off with Cu2 plus and I'm going back to the metal, Cu. What have I got to do? Cu2 plus means it's lost two electrons, therefore I've got to add two back. So I'm adding electrons, it goes on the left-hand side, and I need two to balance it. So you get one mark for that. The second mark is for the anode, so I'm going from Cl minus to Cl2. Remember, chlorine is diatomic. And then, how am I doing that? I've got to take away an electron, so I put an electron on the right-hand side. Then I balance it, so I've got Cl2. Therefore, I need two chlorines on the left. Therefore, I've got to take away two electrons, so I'll put that on the right. Let's have a look at the second part then. So again, very similar here, magnesium bromide. It's a liquid, therefore I only have Mg2 plus and Br minus ions to look at. So Mg2 plus has got to go back to Mg. How does it do that? It's in group 2, so it needs to add two more electrons back on. So I'm adding electrons, put it on the left-hand side, and I'm adding two, so I'll put two there for my first mark. Bromine, or Br minus, my bromide ion, is going back to a bromine molecule, Br2. Again, a halogen, so diatomic. Therefore, how do I do it? Take an electron away, so I put it on the right-hand side. Then balance it, Br2, two bromine ions, and therefore two electrons on the right. And that gets you your second mark. Question three is a little bit tougher then. So you've got calcium sulfate, it's aqueous, so you've also got your hydrogen and your hydroxide ions in there. So you've got to be able to figure out which one is formed. Calcium is reactive because it's in group 2, therefore it's the least reactive one that forms, so it's going to be hydrogen. Hydrogen will turn back into hydrogen gas. Hopefully you could remember that is H2, diatomic again. And then what do I need to do? I've got H plus, similar with your metals, I've got to add an electron on to get back to my actual atom. Then you balance it, I've got two hydrogens on the right, one on the left, so put a 2 there, and therefore I need two electrons back on, so I'll put a 2 there. At the anode, I've either got an OH minus or SO4. Now neither of them are a halide, therefore it's going to be the OH minus. You should remember that OH minus forms oxygen and water, and therefore I've got a minus on the left hand side, so I've got to take an electron away, so I'm going to put it on the right. You then need to balance it, so two H2Os and four OH minuses, therefore I've got to take four electrons away, so I have that there. And finally, part four, Fe2O3. So here, you've got to work out the charges. Ion's a transition metal, you can't just look at the periodic table and go, it's Fe2 plus, Fe3 plus. You've got to figure it out from the equation. So what I'd do is have a look. You know oxygen's in group 6, therefore you should know that's O2 minus. Therefore, my total charges of my negatives is 6 minus, because I've got 3 oxygens. Ion must therefore be 6 plus. I've only got 2 of them. So 6 divided by 2 gives me 3, so both my ions are going to have a 3 plus charge. So I can use that to put in that iron has a charge of 3 plus. You get your first mark for doing that. The second mark is for saying it goes back to Fe. How many electrons do I need to add on? If it's Fe 3 plus, I've got to add 3 electrons on, and that gets you your second mark. At the anode, I've just got oxygen here, so I have O2 minus. On the right-hand side, remember the phone company, O2, so that's your formula for oxygen. And what have I done? Oxygen was in group 6, it's gained 2 electrons to become O2 minus, therefore to turn it back into an oxygen atom, I've got to take 2 electrons away. However, I've then got to balance it. I've got 2 oxygens on the right and only 1 on the left, so I'll put a 2 in front of there. That means I actually need 4 electrons on the right hand side, because I've got 2 oxygens that I've got to take 2 electrons away from. So you get a mark for having 2 O2 minus goes to O2 plus 4 E minus. That's the end of these questions. Hopefully that's made it a little bit clearer for you. If you're not sure, put a comment down below and I can have a chat with you about it. There is a review question, which is write the half equations at the cathode and anode for the electrolysis of molten sodium chloride, NaCl. So there you're only going to have sodium and chlorine ions. So do the half equations and then aqueous sodium sulfate. So figure out of sodium and hydrogen ions, which one's going to form at the cathode, and SO4 and OH minus ions, which one's going to form at the anode. And then explain to me, in terms of electrons, what is happening. That brings this video to an end. Thanks for watching. Hi guys, hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, click on subscribe, visit the website, and have a look at the latest video. Thanks for watching.